pass card goes off the field, or off the track. Kyle Busch leads the field to green in the Xfinity race at Charlotte. And green flag! And Kyle gets a big jump. He's gone. Dang. My goodness. Kyle's gone. How did he get such a big jump? Oh no! And there's a crash! And they're wrecking! Oh no! Oh, hard hit for Tommy Joe Martins. That sucks. He was having a nice run. Well, the announcers jinxed Tommy Joe Martins. They were saying he had... Oh, look at Haley.
Justin Haley.
Going like this. Oh, Tommy Joe Martins with a hard hit.
I can't believe there's not more damage to that car.
And now we're going to have a NASCAR overtime.
Yeah, you wouldn't think it would be driving. Justin Haley hit a ton as well.
He did. Brandon Jones was involved. Wow.
Brandon Jones coming to pit road.
I saw that. Once you saw Gregson Lewis, that was coming from a mile away. Well, now Kyle Busch will have to hold off for another restart.
Precautions we see it time and time again.
So Kyle will not get the win yet. It's not. Don't hand it to him yet.
You get those runs on the bottom, you get them on the top.
That's going to be it. Wow, that was a big hit for Tommy Joe Martins.
Turn two is
that was a big hit.
Start when it's, you know, comes down to the end of these races. Yeah, so we've talked about it all day long.
Wow.
This car's been nervous, right? I mean, and then you get down to the end and you just give it just that little bit extra, and he just got loose and it came around.
Yeah, Harrison Burton was on his outside, got into him, got in the fence. A lot of cars.
Haley's getting out of his car.
Tore up a lot of cars.
See the AMR safety team there tending to Justin Haley.
Gregson got loose in that corner.
See those safety workers.
He got really, really loose and went up the track, and that's what caused the crash.
They did such an unbelievable job working with Ryan Newman after that horrific crash.
Right here.
That took a big hit. You can tell that he's having a tough time getting in the truck there.
See him get loose right here.
Right here, gets loose, and that's what causes the crash. Harrison Burton gets the wall. Hey, Chastain squeaked through. Ross Chastain, Melon Man. He squeaked through that. Barely.
See Justin Haley.
Watch Chastain here. Watch Chastain barely squeak through this wreck. I swear he barely.
Man, I don't know. You think that.
Oh, barely squeak through.
And then, see these two cars.
Wow, what a hard hit for.
That's a shot right there.
And then Haley. Oh, hard hit for Haley, too. Yeah.
I think it knocked his hands off the wheel he hit so hard right there.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, I mean, sometimes we see these wrecks and you think massive impact.
Wow.
And from a driver's perspective, it wasn't that bad.
That was big. Oh boy, this is on. Justin Haley's on board. This is gonna hurt.
You're stuck, I can tell you right now.
That's gonna show his onboard hit right here. Oh, that did not look like a good hit. That was a big hit.
What's happening around you, and
that's what you want to do. You want to take your hands off the wheel and put them somewhere. I remember Chase Elliott did that same thing at Charlotte in 2016 when, in the fall race, when he got wrecked.
Different perspective and opinion.
Or actually, it might have been the Coca-Cola 600 back in 2016. I don't remember. But he took his hands and put them right here and took them off the wheel when he was crashing. He knew. Haley knows too. He knows the right thing to do. When you're wrecking, you take your hands off the steering wheel and put them somewhere.
Again, I hit that wall last
anywhere but the steering wheel.
If you saw me when I got out of the car, I was kind of rolling my wrist. It got caught in the wheel. As it hit the wall, it kind of snapped the wheel. And that's what you got to be careful of and why they take your hands off the wheel.
See, Quinn's talking about what happened to him before.
Steering, the dirt late model guy,
that's why I want to take your hands off the wheel.
Stronger, and it'll break your
my wrist. God, that was a hard hit. That was a couple hard hits for Tommy Joe Martins and Justin Haley.
That Tommy Joe Martins hit was just unbelievable. And then watch outside. Harrison Burton, I mean, he's almost got it sideways in that right rear.
By the way, Daniel Hemric in the A right there, he has fresh tires, so he could have a shot at this win. He's going to have to be pushing Kyle Busch.
Seems like the wall is just kind of straightened right.
Or, well, it depends on what line Busch takes. If he takes the outside or the inside.
Survive right here.
Oh, that's a scary hit.
Well,
for the 11th time.
Wow.
Overtime finish at Charlotte for Xfinity teams. Cedric is second by Kyle Busch.
Well, looks like they're going commercials, so I'll cut the video back to when they go back green for the NASCAR overtime restart, and I'll see you guys in a quick second. Green flag. flag back in the air for the overtime restart. And there we go. Cindric kept up with Kyle Busch this time. Use him up, Cindric. Don't be afraid to use him. Oh, Harrison Burton has a tire rub from that crash, as expected. Here comes Ross to the bottom of Burton. Come on, Cindric, hold off Kyle. Do not let Kyle win. No, don't let him go to the outside.
He didn't let him have the bottom that time.
Wait, flag. One lap to go, sponsored by Credit One Bank.
One lap to go. That's the white and the next flag.
Come on, Cindric, hold on. Hold back Kyle. Oh, here comes Kyle with a big run to the inside.
Here comes Kyle to the inside.
What do you do, Cindric?
Ooh.
Ooh. They're getting close. Oh, Kyle's gonna get it. No! Come on now. Damn you, Kyle. You gotta ruin everything, don't you, you dick. I'm not even waving the flag for you, no. That's what I do with the flag for you. You ruin everything, you dick. You dick. You ruin everything, don't you? You absolutely ruin everything. You ruined Darlington on Wednesday night.
You could see Austin Cindric sailed it off into turn three. You saw how loose he got just trying to hold on to Kyle Busch.
You ruined tonight.
He could possibly do. Drove it off into turn one.
Cindric tried his damnedest, though.
Right here to Kyle Busch. Man, the side draft is on going down the back
street. I thought they were going to hit right there.
Man, if you're getting your Hemrick, you're thinking, oh, come on, boys. Come on, boys. But Kyle Busch drove that thing off in there way, way deep.
So damn it.
Won the race.
Of course Kyle had to win. He's got to ruin everything, doesn't he?
For the sixth time.
He's got to ruin every single race, doesn't he?
Finishes before getting their first win, and so we hope it comes for him.
That's a nice paint scheme on the 22, though, I won't lie.
Been competitive in the last couple of weeks, showing a lot of speed.
Needed that, man. Got beat up first right off the bat at, you know, the first few races. Really beat up, and to come out swinging right here, hats off to him.
Boo!
Spring win.
Boo!
The ninth.
Boo!
Is the best all time.
Too bad there aren't fans at the track.
He did.
He'd be being booed right now if there were. He's lucky. That's why he ran these races without fans at the track. So he knows he couldn't be booed by the fans at the track because there's no fans at the track due to coronavirus. So.
Back to fifth.
I know. I just looked down and saw that unbelievable recovery for him.
Allgaier got back to fifth.
A dash.
After crashing.
And he was in a wreck.
Yeah. Brett Moffitt,
maybe a
top
couple
10.
Of them.
Kyle, you need to put on your mask. You can catch Corona.
Great job by him. Brandon Brown, 8. Another top 10 for Harrison Burton.
You gotta take this crap serious. You're gonna catch Corona if you don't put on your mask.
Nice job by a number of drivers. But none of them had what it takes to beat Kyle Busch tonight. He's a winner again, Matt. 17.
Did you see that face he made? What was that?
Right here at the Charlotte Motor Speedway, a second place finish.
What was that?
Tonight, the word would be recovery and execution. The speeding penalty, you recovered, and then you got the lead back on the last lap.
Yeah. I thought choosing the outside was the right way, but obviously it wasn't. I don't know. But those guys put up a whale of a fight tonight on restarts. I was really surprised by that. I guess I'm not very good at it anymore. But overall, I really want to thank M&M's, but more importantly, I want to wish the 2020 class from App State. Congratulations on obviously getting their diplomas this year. It's a little different, I know, but hopefully this lift your spirits a little bit anyways. We won for you. We took all the rest of them big houses down tonight, so it was pretty cool to score a win here in Charlotte, as always.
Now, those graduates are going to be beginning their career. Your legacy in this series, 97 wins, 3 away from 100. What means the most to you about what you've recorded during your time in Xfinity?
I would say the biggest thing is just working with so many different teams, so many different crew sheets, having the opportunity to win with a lot of them, if not all of them, and just being able to go out there and work with a lot of cool guys, a lot of people that have helped me along the way and gotten me to this point, but a lot of great sponsors as well, too, over the years, and again, another shout-out to M&M's and Interstate Batteries, Ream, Snickers, Skittles, Rowdy Energy. It's nice to be able to get all those guys in victory lane here in the Xfinity Series. Appreciate them helping me out in these final 5, 6, however many races I need to get to close it out for getting 100.
What an impressive display of execution on that final restart, and to take it back and get.
Just wanted to listen to what he had to say.
And it's third win.
And of course, there's Samantha. Even though she's not at the track, we still have to see her, even in tweet form. Of course.
Last lap, 97th win. Great job, babe. And Samantha get his shirt and tie.
I mean, we don't know if he's won yet. He's still got post-race inspection to go through. And Jimmy Johnson failed post-race inspection last night for the Cup race. Forgot to mention that in the Cup reaction video, but he did. He failed post-race inspection. Got put all the way back to last. So that means Chase Elliott got second. That's even worse than what happened last night. That leaves an even bigger salty taste in my mouth. But I'll admit, I have no clue what App State is. Not a clue. So I don't even know what that is, honestly. But disappointed, but we still got post-race inspection to go through. I mean, Jimmy Johnson failed last night from second. Kyle could fail today from first. We don't know. Well, and look at that, Ross Chastain, after getting in the wall, after getting in Timmy Hill's oil earlier, finishes fourth, and Allgaier finishes fifth, after getting also in a wreck.
Well, the fun meter was certainly...
And there's Austin Cindric.
...watching at home from your seat. What could you have done different, Austin?
It's hard to tell. I'm just really proud of this team. This F14 Mustang, you know, Brian and I were talking about it on the radio. You and I talked about it on the drive to the track today. This was our turning point last year. You know, it was probably one of my worst races last year. And to almost beat the best in the business on worst tires, I never lifted into three until I knew I was done. But
he never lifted into three until he knew he was done.
These guys obviously worked really hard, really proud of what we unloaded with. It's definitely a lot of unknowns.
In the Cup cars, that's not a problem due to the package.
I don't want to win so bad.
He's still looking for that first win on an oval. But what a great kid.
Yep, it was almost tonight.
A performance behind the wheel tonight, that double deuce.
Did a great job, and so did you. Thanks for all your hard work down there. Doing it solo tonight. So Kyle Busch gets his 97th career victory.
The truck race tomorrow night and the Cup Series
tomorrow night.
On Wednesday night. Ugh.
Outdoors truck series at Charlotte Motor Speedway.
Yesterday's Coca-Cola 600 sucked, so.
Here this evening, and then Wednesday.
They're going to commercial. When they go to commercial, that'll be the end of the reaction, so. You know? Whoa, Kyle. Wow, threaded the needle between those two cars. Briscoe's in. Who is that? The 99. I'm not sure who the 99 is. But. Kyle's helmet just hanging in there. Well, going to commercial. There it is. That's going to be the end of this reaction. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you enjoy my content. And comment down below what you thought about Kyle Busch winning. Alright, bye guys.